Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be talking about how to grow your social media fast, because as you all probably know, there is so much good benefits of like having a following in Instagram or any other social account, like getting invited to some events, like brand trips, getting paid to post contact, getting free stuff. It all like comes together and there's literally no downside to post contact, so it's so good. And I've been posting on Instagram and TikTok for like, I don't know even how many years, but like a few years, and I've grown my account to total of 200k in all the platforms now. But as you all know, it wasn't always like that. Everyone needs to start from something. So now I want to share exactly how I did it, how I started, and give you the best tips that no one knows. So if you wanted to be an influencer yourself in doing this kind of things, work from home, manage yourself, and just do all these good things at home, then this video is perfect for you. Sit back, focus up, and enjoy. And also you can make some notes. So, step one is targeting your ICP. Before you even start to post any content, you should figure out who you're gonna post like content for, like what kind of content you're going to create. Who is your audience that you want to reach out? What kind of content do you want to give them? What do you love to do? I always see some young influencers and the biggest mistake they're doing is not targeting their audience, not targeting their market, not targeting their contact. They're just making videos for the sake of making videos. They don't know what they're doing. They don't have any purpose or goals. They just think they can send a video, it can go viral. And yes, there's some few people that did it and are very successful, but it's very rare. It doesn't work like that. You need luck to be succeed on that. Like just to post a video of you being pretty and doing nothing. I'm not saying it's not working. There are some girls that did very well with that, but you need more. These days you need more because there is so much girls like that and it's very rare. It's one of a kind, like to go viral just from being pretty and some sing some maybe a nice song or something. So you're gonna be needing more than that and really planning and targeting your ICP, as I said. Also, if you're not speaking to some specific demographic, then the social media algorithm won't know where to send your content. So the result is going to be either low views, awful engagement, or shadow bans, which we don't want that. So I would say go for something you're very passionate about, like you very like to do, because I don't know if anyone likes that. I believe they do, but for example myself, if I do something I love, I do it perfectly. I'm so creative, I have so much ideas and different ways and original ways to film the kind of contact, and I'm very creative because I love it and I live it, and this is, I'm very passionate about it. So don't force yourself to do something you think might be successful but it's not really talking to you, or you have no experience about it or no passionate about it. Like do something you really feel connected with and you have the knowledge about it, and if you don't have the knowledge it's also okay, but you can do some research and bring yourself to your contact. Show who you are. Don't look for other people. You can get inspiration, obviously, always. I'm doing it always, it's all good. But you need to take the inspiration and bring yourself to your contact and mix it together, and it will be the perfect combo, I'm telling you. It will be a game over for all of you. Cause it will be also something that very popular but very unique, cause there's only one of you and no one else will think about this kind of ideas, because you created that, you bring it yourself, and people will love it. And also that way you will be so excited to make the contact because you love doing that. So let's say you achieve everyone's goal in life to do something they love, to work in something they love, and to wake up with a smile every morning. Okay, let's go to work. Not like, oh, I can't be bothered doing this right now. Like, you'll be passionate about it, you love to doing it. Also, you can pick something that other people are going about it, like for example something with cooking or something that has to do with beauty. What you see is viral, then it's good to, like I said, copy it, but bring yourself to it. Don't do like one-on-one the same, because it won't go viral because someone else already did it. So will be like, oh yeah, I've seen it before, but like it's not creative. So it's very important to see trends and to be aware and to use like viral, like reels, for example, viral audio and something like songs that are very popping. It's very good, but also do it like in your way. Step two is the secret. Start doing your contact so much better. Now that you know who you want to target, you need to know how to make very high quality contact that people will see and go crazy about it. Like, you need to be proud of what you're posting. Like, for example, me, if I have like a very good contact that I've created, like I'm so excited to post it that I can't even wait to a good hour that I think it's good to like post about, and like I just want to post it already. I want everyone to see it. I'm proud of what I'm doing. It makes it more fun, more quality. It always better results. Like, there are some things that I just like, okay, I just need to post something and I don't have something like so good to post, but I don't want to also like not posting. I want to keep it like, you know, popping. So every time I posted something I wasn't like really happy about, it ended up me deleting that, or like it didn't have like the best results. So you need to really post something that you're very proud of. It's a bit hard work, but trust me, it's worth it. Also, I see tons of beginners that are making the same mistake that I used to do. So this is what you need to do basically to have a good contact. So you're gonna need good lighting. Good lighting is everything, especially in pictures, because you can have the most beautiful background, the most beautiful sunset, city view or whatever, but as long as your lighting is not good, you lose everything. Because let's say sunset, for example, behind you it's a beautiful crazy sunset, all the skies are like pink, purple, whatever, orange, blue, yellow, I don't know, all the combo, like the perfect sunset, okay, but you are so dark because, you know, it's hard to catch the sunset and you at the same time without lighting or something. It's just gonna ruin everything. Like, you're gonna lose all the sunset and you're gonna be so dark and you won't even want to post these things. And also something that I very believe in is just to film from your iPhone. Be as authentic as you can. It always works better. Don't put tons of like filters, makeup. Make sure you feel comfortable as well, but just film it for your iPhone, keep it simple. It always works better on social media. Your audience always wants to feel that you're not like higher than them or better than them. They want you to feel that you are one of them and they can do what you do. This is what's going to buy them and make them want to follow you, wants to get inspiration by you, because they can feel like they can get to your level. And like I said, keep editing to the minimum. Don't. Like, it's very obvious if someone is doing too much Photoshop or editing, or like there are some pictures that look like even a picture, like unreal photos. So you don't want to do that. That's not going to work. The best things that are working for me is to post either a very good view and a very good location, or a selfie, something that is very like facial, very close to your face. Not something like very far or like hiding. Obviously you can post some style contact. It's everything is up to what you want to show, what kind of audience you want to target. But if you want to be like a model like me doing like brand deals and stuff, then what's worked for me the best is like maximum pictures, like so close that like you can see only till the legs, like from here till the legs. And it works the best for me, so I would recommend that. Also very high quality. It's important, don't post like blurry pictures unless they're very like style or something that this I really like to do. But make sure you have some good face pictures that people can see who you are, because I don't know, me for example, if I go and look on some Instagram account, for the example, some Instagram account, and I don't see like face, I just see like clothing and like cool pictures but no face, then I won't want to follow, because I don't know who I'm following after. Like, I need to see the face as well. Also, this is a secret that not a lot of people know, and I feel like that everyone who knows it are very popping TikTok reels, everything. Don't be afraid to do like silly things, like funny things, things that you might like get attention but the wrong attention. It's not the best, but sometimes you can do it, and trust me, your video will be super viral. Like, doing some little mistakes in the title or say something funny, make sure that the beginning of the video is like really like energetic and catching the attention of the people, so they'll want to stay till the last minute of the video, so they want to keep and watch the entire video. This is very, very good, especially in TikTok. You need to make it like super interesting, super funny, super crazy, be creative. Don't be shy, don't be shy to post. And also, if you don't have like much of followers to begin with, don't be shy to just start post content. Like, I've seen so many girls that started to post like blogger lifestyle, like this is what I got from Zara and from, I don't know, like starting to showing like clothing they got, like shoes they got, what they think that works with what. And okay, maybe the beginning was like, okay, what this girl is doing, but now they are popping and they are selling so much and they're working with so much brands and they're getting so much clothes and they're so stylish. So always treat your followers like you already have the amount of followers that you want. Like, you know what Rihanna say, fake it till you make it. This is exactly how you need to do it, and trust me, it works. Okay, so step 3 is posting daily. You need to keep posting, okay? The fact that you post one picture in a while, not gonna help you. Again, there are some girls that are doing it and super successful, but it's very rare. Not everyone is doing it. And as long as you post more, you higher your chance to go viral, okay? Because let's say I post one video and let's say I wait for him to go viral, not much is going to happen. But if I post a few and two of them getting viral at the same time, I get so much more views. Also, if you're gonna post daily, the algorithm gonna like it and gonna like push your post. It works in every platform, trust me, Instagram, TikTok. To keep posting, it's very, very important, especially as a beginner. If you have like lots of followers, like few millions, obviously you can post a few posts in a week and not, you don't need to post daily, but you can also lose your followers as well if you stop posting. So keep posting. Very high quality content. Don't just post whatever because you want to keep post daily. It's important to keep posting, but keep it high quality as well. Don't just like, okay, I don't have what to post, so I'll just post that. No, this is not good. Trust me, I've did it and it's never worked. Step 4, engagement hacking. It's so, so, so important. I know everything I say is important, but this is specifically, it's so important to contact with your audience, to engagement with them, to keep asking them their opinion about things, keep replying them back sometimes, liking their comments, showing them that you actually care about their opinion. They have like the influence on you too. You don't just influence them, they can influence you too, and trust me, they're gonna love it. They're gonna be super involved, and whenever you're going to post content that you want to sell or your own brand, they're gonna buy it. They're gonna want to be involved, they're gonna want to help you because they'll feel like they know you, they'll feel like you're one of them, they'll feel like you're their friend. So it's very important to keep it engagement and do like a lot of like questions in your story, like, okay, ask like 5 questions about me that you would like to know and answer some, the best of like 5 questions that you want to answer. Or like even the smallest things, like you're in some store and you don't know which bag to choose, which shoes to choose, post in your story, let your audience help you, okay, choose this one or this one, help me. And like, keep sharing them, keep involving them in your life. It's very, very important as well, I'm telling you. Also, giveaway and all these kind of stories are always working because people like gifts, as everyone knows, and they're going to like promote you as well. Like, it's like a free ad. Let's say you can add, like, if you want to be part of the giveaway, you need to follow me and to share it in your story. You can gain so much followers from that, so much engagement. Like, as long as people sharing you, people talking about you, people sharing your contact, it's hiring your engagement, and the algorithm is going to blow up. Also, as an influencer, you're gonna meet a lot of other influencers in some events, and you're gonna work with them in the same brand, and you're gonna have even some commercials and like lots of kind of ways to meet other influencers. And it's so important to engage with them and to post them on your story and to make them share your stories, because you can get to their to their audience and they can get to your audience, it will be like benefits for both sides. So it's also very important to be nice to everyone, don't disrespect anyone. There are some people with lower amount of followers, but they are popping and they have so much like good engagement and the algorithm loves them, so they might have even more let's say story views than you, more comments than you, more buyers than you. So don't disrespect anyone, be nice to everyone, always be friendly and always try to make them to share you in their story and also do the opposite. And this is a very, very good way to keep going and to keep growing and to get to all the audience. So as I was saying, it's very important to also keep posting stories, make them involved, like show them everything you're doing, even if you feel uncomfortable with that. Like I know sometimes like you just want to shut off from your phone and enjoy like your vacation or whatever, but try to push hard on that, try to keep them involved, post stories every day, make sure they know what you're doing, who you are, and this way they'll feel connected to you. So guys, this is what I was talking about today. And like I said, I'm going to post weekly uploads about social media, about how I travel so much and how can I afford traveling the entire world and how to make smaller business and to make a lot of money from staying at home, from social media and all these kind of things. So see you in the next video. Love you guys.